first two terms, you sponsored some legislation centered around employment. Just curious what you see that might be coming up this session that would be related to employment issues.
Well, I think the biggest thing is, when you're talking about employment, the biggest thing is the skill set and also education. So I think as long as it's going to be a funding system, you follow the money, and in order to have employment, you got to have people that are qualified to do it. So I think when you partner in with places like Wiregrass, I'm a product for Wiregrass, right there, okay. But as an EMT program and paramedic program, and you know, by me having the opportunity to have a hands-on situation, technical trades, things like that, it's very important that we get the people, especially in my district, which is a more urban district, that we have to prepare people. A lot of times in urban communities, you have a lot of crime, you have a lot of different things going on, and the employment is low, but a lot of times it's just not because of the employment, because of the jobs, it's because people are not qualified for the jobs. A lot of people, they drop out, they don't have the grades, and they don't have the support systems, even at home. A lot of times you have single parent homes, and that's a struggle in itself. So a lot of these young men especially feel like they gotta sometimes help mommy, you know, with the bills. So education at that point is not relevant to them. They feel that. So they go out, get jobs, and sometimes get involved with things that are negative in the community. Maybe joining gangs, or perhaps, you know, just robbing and just finding a way, drugs, to make ends meet. So I think here, especially in Valdosta, I'd like to, you know, commend Dr. Anderson and her staff that they're doing so much through the dual enrollment situation there to get these kids involved, especially when they're juniors. They need to have that extra support, because we got to have our kids ready as soon as they get out of high school, because if we let them, and to be honest, once they get out of high school, a lot of them, there's no more education after that. It's, I got to get out and get me a job. And all of you know, most of you know, that once you get out of high school, you get a job, and you got a family going, guess what? Education, the possibility of getting involved in more education, is so far away that it makes it hard. So I think through the dual enrollment program, that if we just get our inner city people, work with them, embrace them, figure out a way that we can get them involved in education, and like we say, at the 11th grade, 12th grade, get them involved, and let's put in their minds, don't let this be the end. Even when you graduate from a dual enrollment program, hey, we got VSU here. We got other colleges here that the credits can roll over and be accepted. And that's something that I'm glad we had the hindsight to see that, just because you go from this school that you can't transfer. But that was a great thing that Dr. McKinney and they got together and say, let's make it work. Let's continue the education that we need for these people, because a more educated community that you have, more jobs are going to be coming here. You know, we can't really, at this point, I don't think, we can't have someone like Microsoft, Google, all those people come to Valdosta. You know why? We won't have enough educated people that's their specialties. But I think that if we continue to push dual enrollment, and it's going to be our jobs up here to make sure we continue to get the funding we need for education, but specifically for Wiregrass, VSU, whoever's out there that we can help, because we're in this thing together. If we turn our heads and say that's an urban situation, guess what? You're still going to be affected by it one way or the other. So I'm saying that as long as we can push for more funding, when it comes down to education, that money comes into our community especially, and then we put it into these kids in the urban community, well, really everybody, but at the same time, that's the high-risk area that I serve. And I know what I hear day in, day out, Dexter, we need jobs, Dexter, we need jobs. But I'm telling them continually, we need educated people. We got to push these kids to finish school. They have to finish school in order to get that job. And once they get that job, they can have the money they need to help support their families. And I think, you know, most people, they get enough encouragement in these mentor programs we have, I think they can feel good about themselves when they're educated and they have a job and they're good citizens here. So with that said, I think we just need to work hard to when we see anybody in this community, I know this is not on your paper, but when we see anybody in this situation, I'm gonna challenge all of you this, that when you see young people, no matter what color they are, what side of the tracks they're from, whatever the situation is, just encourage them somehow. I don't care if it's just a smile. Just look at them and just give them that smile. Give them that encouragement. Say, you know what? You can do anything you want in life. You can be anybody that you want in life. I came from the South Side. I still live in the South Side. I'm never going to leave the South Side because I want to let those boys and girls know in my neighborhood, in the parks that I go to, all around me, I want to let them know, you know what? I never thought I could be a city councilman, but somebody told me that you can do it. And then I didn't think I would ever probably be a state representative. But Larry Hansen told me, that's the story. Remember that story you told me sitting there? I ain't gonna tell you everything he said, but Larry Hansen told me, he said, you don't make a great state representative. Guess what? I'm here. And there's people told me I could make a great president, so who knows?